हाय एवरीवन, दिस इज रूचा एंड आई वेलकम यू टू माय व्लॉग। आज का दिन थोड़ा खास है। खास क्यों है? क्योंकि आज है रामनवमी। भगवान राम जी का आज के दिन इस पृथ्वी पे जन्म हुआ था। वैसे जन्म तो नहीं कह सकते, भगवान ऐसे जन्म तो नहीं लेते हैं, लेकिन उनका आगमन हुआ था ऐसे कह सकते हैं। तो आप सभी को इस पावन अवसर पे बहुत बहुत शुभकामनाएं। So on the ninth day of the bright fortnight of the month of Chaitra is the day of Ram Navami when Bhagwan Ram appeared on this planet. So you may ask how long back was this? Currently we are in Kali Yuga, which is we've already completed 5000 years. Before Kali Yuga was Dwapar Yuga, which lasted about 800,000 years. And before Dwapar Yuga was Treta Yuga, that's when Lord Ram appeared. And in Treta Yuga lasted for about 1200,000 years. So that means at least 2 million years ago, Bhagwan Ram had appeared. Bhagwan Ram was born to, or he appeared to Dashrath Maharaj and Kaushalya Devi in Ayodhya. Dashrath Maharaj was the king of Ayodhya and he had three wives, Kaushalya, Sumitra and Kaikeyi. Lord Ram was the eldest son of Dashrath Maharaj and the other three sons were Lakshman, Bharat and Shatrughna. So the story of the life of Lord Ram has been very beautifully written in the Ramayana, and we all know the story of Ramayana since our childhood. So Dashrath Maharaj wanted to retire and he wanted to coronate Lord Ram as the next king of Ayodhya, but destiny had other plans, and Dashrath Maharaj's wife Kaikeyi said, my son Bharat should become the king of Ayodhya, and you banish Lord Ram into exile for 14 years. So Dashrath Maharaj had given this promise to Kaikeyi because of some past favors that she had done for him. So he told Lord Ram, and a Kshatriya never goes back on his promise. So, and Lord Ram, being the most obedient son, obeyed the instructions and wish of his father, and he went into exile along with his brother Lakshman and wife Sita. While he was in exile for 14 years, you know, they were roaming all over the country, and at one spot the evil Ravan came and kidnapped his wife Sita Devi, and he took her to Lanka. So from there the search for Sita Devi started, and Lord Ram mobilized an army of monkeys, or the Vanar Sena as it is called, and he built a bridge across India to Sri Lanka over the ocean, and he entered Lanka, and he in a war he destroyed Ravan and he freed his wife Sita Devi. So in his avatar, Bhagwan Ram gave us a few lessons in as the ideal king, which shows where he established the highest principles of dharma, and he showed us what good governance actually is. The most ideal son, obedient son for his parents, and he was also a capable and an able leader. He set an example of how a king should be and how a kingdom should be run. What is governance? And he set the highest example for that. His kingdom, everybody was happy, satisfied and content. All the people were happy, and hence it was known as Ram Rajya. The king to be an ideal human. There were no complications in his relationship with his wife, with his siblings. Having strength of character, Lord Ram was a very exceptional, extraordinary student when he was studying. He had great strength of not just physical strength, but of strength of character. He understood that when his wife was kidnapped, he could not do it, he could not rescue her alone. So he understood that he has to make allies. So he made allies with people who were, you know, probably not well trained for the job. So he trained them. He delegated authorities to them and powers to them. He saw the latent potential in them, and he put his entire trust and faith in them and got them to do such a humongous task of building the bridge across India to Sri Lanka. And you know, he organized all his resources through right planning and execution, and also crisis management was one of the biggest lessons that we can learn. Obviously Lord Ram's life was not a bed of roses. When his wife was kidnapped by Ravan, it's not easy you know, to maintain one's cool and you know, strategize and plan everything in order to rescue her. So so one very critical quality that we see in him is his level-headedness and crisis management skills, and he did not compromise on code of conduct and ethic. at one point in time during the war or during the battle, Ravan was rendered helpless. He lost his weapons or he was weaponless. Lord Ram could have killed him, but no. His ethics prevailed and he said, no, I will not attack somebody who is without weapons. So all in all, that is these are some of my learnings, my humble learnings from Lord Ram and the Ramayana and all that he had to go through and all that he went through, and he emerged victorious. So it's how we look at it. This is how I look at it. So on this auspicious occasion of Ram Navami, friends, I have another small surprise for you. There are various ways of worshipping Bhagwan Ram. Some do Abhishek, some do Puja, some do fasting, there are many other methods. I thought I would worship him with a beautiful painting that I would like to offer to him. Now this is a Mithila painting which I want to make, and I would love if you could join me while I'll create this painting. So why Mithila painting is because Mithila painting originated in Mithila Nagari, which is on the border of Nepal and Bihar, you know, where Sita Devi lived. So it originated on this day of Sita Swayamvar, where Janak Maharaj, who was the father of Sita Devi, told all his people in his kingdom that you should, you know, decorate Mithila Nagari on the occasion of my daughter's wedding. And that's when all the women of Mithila Nagari came out and painted the entire city with these beautiful art form called, which evolved at that time, and it is known as, today it is known as Madhubani paintings, because it was in the Madhubani area. I have prepared a small sketch of Sita Swayamvar, where she and Bhagwan Ram are, you know, getting married. So I would like you to join me in completing this painting. And while I create this painting, what you will hear in the backdrop is a beautiful rendition by my dear friend Sangeeta, Sangeeta Amerikar, whose video you would have seen already. And if not, I'll put the link in the description box. She's a fantastic singer and she's very kindly agreed to send us a recording of one of the Ram Bhajans for this video. Mata's Vivah is complete on this occasion of Ram Navami. I have not used paints. I have just used these gel pens to fill in these lines, because Madhubani paintings and art is more of, you know, a lot of intricate lines and circles and dots. So friends, if you like today's episode on Ram Navami, please do not forget to like, share and subscribe to my YouTube channel by clicking the subscribe button below. Thank you for watching.